This is Coding Math Mini number 2, Linear Interpolation. In the first mini, we created a normalize function. This took a value in a range and returned a number from 0 to 1, indicating where that value was located in that range. Linear interpolation is the exact opposite of this. You start with a range and a normalized value, and it will return the value in that range that the normalized value points to. For example, say your range is the number of the days in the year, 0 to 365. And you want to know which day of the year corresponds to 0.75. Like with normalize, when the range starts at 0, this is very easy. Just multiply the max by the normal value, and you get 273.75. So at 6 p.m. on the 274th day of the year, you'll be at 75% of the way through the year. But now, what if our range does not start at 0? Say you had an object that you wanted to draw on the screen somewhere between 100 and 450 pixels on the x-axis. But you have a normalized value from 0 to 1 that will indicate which position it should be drawn. Say that value is 0.37. So your range is 100 to 450. The size of the range is 350. You multiply the range by the normal value, and that gives you 129.5. But that represents an offset from the minimum value here. So to get the final value, you need to add the minimum to that, which gives you 229.5. Mathematically, this is max minus min times norm plus min. Max minus min is the range. You multiply that times the normal value and add min. Now we can create this function, which is usually called LIRP, short for linear interpolation. This takes a normal value, a min, and a max for the range, and returns a value in that range. Like the normalize function, this is extremely flexible. It takes any numbers for any of the parameters and will automatically adjust to give you sensible results. You can even pass in a normalized value greater than 1 or less than 0, and it will still return a value that makes sense. So what would you use this for? Well, again, like normalize, there are countless uses. A great one is for animating, especially when you have multiple properties that you want to animate at the same time. Here's a project I already created using the usual animation template. First, I set a bunch of min and max values for x, y, alpha, and radius, and a value t, which will go from 0 to 1 as the normal value. Then there's the LIRP function, then the update function, which gets called in each frame. This clears the canvas and sets the global alpha. Now right off the bat, we have something interesting here. Notice that I'm passing the min and max alpha values in reverse order. So this means that when t is 0, LIRP will return max alpha, and when t is 1, it will return min alpha. After that, I just draw a circle, using LIRP to get the x, y, and radius values. Finally, I just increment t slightly, and if it goes past 1, reset it to 0. And we test this, and we have a nice smooth animation. Notice that while x, y, and radius all increase, the alpha goes from 1, fully opaque, and transitions to 0, fully transparent. Now, animation is only one use for the LIRP function. Throw this in your utility library with norm, and as long as you keep it in mind, I'm sure you'll find uses for it all over the place.